Hello and welcome. In this tutorial video, we're going to demonstrate our AI supervised module, Surface Detection, suitable especially for detection of scratches, cracks, and other defects on a highly variable background. To start training your dataset, you can either add images directly or add folders. We've already added OK and Not Good prefixes to each image. If you wish to add a prefix within PicCat Vision, add each folder individually and type a prefix once you have selected the target folder. Now we are going to add the Surface Detection module and navigate to the Training tab in order to configure your dataset for training. Surface Detection is a supervised AI module. Therefore, detailed annotations must be performed by the end user. If you wish to perform annotations for more than one category, open the Class Manager, create additional classes, and select it and perform annotations. You can annotate by using the brush and polygon drawing tools. To use the brush, ensure the brush is selected from the tools panel and start drawing within the defective areas. If you wish, you may change the brush size. If the defect is large, or if you'd prefer using the polygon tool, select the polygon tool from the tools panel and click on several points around the defective area. When you've finished drawing the polygon points, right-click to create the polygon annotation. In settings, you have three options for surface detection. Fast detects a wide range of defects, however, can suffer from a higher amount of false positives, good parts evaluated as bad by the software. With faster training time and reduced options of viewfinder sizes, this type does not require large datasets. However, for higher performance on some applications, precise option would be more suitable. Precise. This type works well with smaller defects, such as scratches, cracks, and others. However, it usually requires more training data to perform well. Training time is usually longer. Viewfinder and ignore functions are not available. After attempting training on fast option, this type is usually the next to be considered for higher performance on some applications. Experimental. This type may work well for smaller defects, however, it usually requires a lot more training data, and it is our experimental type, meaning that may not perform well in some applications. Training time is usually longer and more options of viewfinder sizes. The ignore function present in fast and experimental, it is not used very often. However, it is designed to inform the neural network not to learn or ignore the surroundings of its annotation. It is designed for areas you are not confident it is a defect while performing annotations. It does not work like the mask module. Once a few images have been annotated, we can click on Start Training. Depending on which type of surface detection settings you select, different augmentation options are available. For detailed information on them, please access our Surface Detection Knowledge Base article. Initially, we recommend to not change the standard augmentation parameters in order to verify how well the model performed with the default values. Training time depends mainly on your dataset size, image resolution, GPU power, and which settings of surface detection you selected. It usually takes from a few minutes to hours. The loss function graph will indicate the appropriate time to stop training. When the graph has stopped decreasing or either dropped between or below the green horizontal lines. For more information, please access our knowledge base training article. Once training is completed, we select the model to validate it and click on Preview to verify the results. Evaluation rules can be set to define defect quantity and threshold values regarding any class name or to a specific class. The evaluation rules can be configured to refer to defect count, edge length, or the defect area in pixels. Select a comparison symbol and define a value. You can add as many evaluation rules as you wish. Evaluation rules will be applied to the trained model and classify images as OK or not good. OK images are marked with a green ribbon and no heat maps, while not good images are marked with red ribbon and precise heat maps on defective areas. The final step is the report section, where you are able to verify the model's statistics and download a report. In order to preview statistics results, we are going to classify images as OK or not good, or either set images by file name, then click on Show Results button. The model statistics are displayed with a confusion matrix, predicted versus actual, displaying also figures for recall, precision, average processing time, minimum processing time, and maximum processing time. To download the HTML report, click on Download Report and open the HTML file. Thank you for watching.